My name is Professor Paul Townsend. I'm Executive Dean and Pro-Vice-Chancellor of Health and Medical Sciences, and I'm also a full research professor. My vision for One Health, One Medicine is that we've quite clearly seen in the last couple of years how we interact with our environment, how the environment interacts with us. And when you look at the skill set and the expertise that we've got across the university, they need to interact and engage in a continuum. Then everything we do, all the way from fundamental research, psychology research, mathematics, STEM subjects, all the way through to the arts and understanding, will fit into that One Health, One Medicine vision. So a couple of projects that fit into that vision. One, very timely, is the development of a very sensitive and accurate COVID detection system. Another great example, much more longer term, is the early prediction of disease and understanding wellness. So Emily's research in terms of One Health, One Medicine is pivotal. It's exactly an exemplar of what the whole philosophy is. Working in that kind of context and looking at how people can educate, people are being educated, and understanding the behaviour and application thereof is a great behavioural exemplar of One Health, One Medicine.
My name is Professor Emily Farren. I'm a member of the School of Psychology and I'm in the Faculty of Health and Medical Science. My research involves working with school children and individuals with neurodevelopmental disorders. And my main interest is in spatial cognition. So what do I mean by spatial cognition? Well, we're all doing spatial activities all the time, whether it's fitting things into a cupboard, packing a suitcase. So over the last 12 months, I've been working more on my research, where we're thinking about the relationship between spatial ability and mathematics in school children. So this came about because there's a growing literature which linked spatial abilities to STEM subjects. So this is science, technology, engineering, and maths. And in collaboration with Katie Gilligan-Lee, who's also in the School of Psychology, we've been showing that there's a relationship between spatial abilities and mathematics in primary school children. If you train spatial ability, so if children are given lots more opportunities to do spatial tasks, they not only get better in spatial ability, they also get better in maths ability. One of my current projects is funded by the Leverhulme Trust, and we're really excited that we're working with Lego, because Lego is really popular and very accessible for children. And we're interested in the association between Lego and mathematics. So by doing this research, we hope to identify how Lego construction activities can improve maths abilities in children. We hope to provide evidence to improve educational practice, and we hope to long term help children to gain entry into STEM industries.